Hi viewers, welcome to AN Technologies. Today I am going to explain you about Oracle basics. So next we will see what is Oracle. So Oracle is nothing but it's a relational database management system, product or application. Okay, so we have two types of database. One is a database management system, another one is relational database management systems. We can create a relation between tables and tables like that we can create in RDBMS. Okay, so this product released in 1979 by Oracle Corporation. It is a backend tool. Backend tool means there are two tools. One is a frontend, another one is a backend tool. See, frontend means if you open any website, there they will ask some information in the form of forms. Okay, so there we will enter some information. The data will be saved. So the view is known as front end. The form where we are it is displaying, that is known as front end. And whatever the data we are typing in the particular form, that one will be saved in database tools. That database tools are known as backend tools. Okay, so next, can install on any OS. This Oracle application can install on any OS, that's why it is known as independent platform. So next we will see what is independent dependent platform and independent platform. So it is having both interfaces, GUI, CUI, whichever we want we can use. So see, GUI means graphical user interface, and CUI means character user or command user interface. Both interfaces will have in Oracle. Okay, whatever we want we can use. If you want, you can use GUI or otherwise CUI also. Next, GUI means there we will get some options and some layouts, these and all things we will get in CUI. Means in CUI we won't get that options, layouts. The screen will be black and white like MS DOS. Okay, there whatever we want to get or whatever we want to save, we have to use commands only. Next, types of apps: front end, back end. So for front end, mostly front end means, you know, only I told you. Suppose if you take any application or any website, there you will able to see some forms like that. There we will enter the data. Okay, so that view is known as front end. Whatever that form is there, that is known as front end. Okay, next, back end. Whatever back end, whatever we will save that data in the particular forms, that one will be stored in backend tools. For backend tools, examples are SQL Server, Oracle. Okay, next, platforms. Platform is nothing but combination of OS and processor. Means, so applications, operating system and processor combination is known as platforms. So we have two types of platforms. One is dependent, another one is independent. A dependent means the application in that dependent platform, the application will work in specific OS and processor, like Microsoft SQL Server. So Microsoft SQL Server Microsoft SQL Server will work on only Windows operating system only. Okay, it won't work in other operating systems. So that is why it's known as dependent platform. SQL Server is a dependent platform. Next, independent platform means it will work on any OS, like Windows also it will work, Mac also it will work, Linux, Unix, any OS it will work. Okay, so mostly we use Oracle in independent platforms. So next we will see User interfaces. See, we have two types of user interfaces. Graphical user interface, CUI. CUI means a command or character user interface. In GUI, we don't have to write queries to work with this, like Windows. See, in GUI interface, we no need to write queries. There will have some options, tools, and icons. So many features will be there. Okay, we can use. Next, in CUI, we have to write queries. The only one option is writing queries, like MS DOS. In MS, in same to MS DOS, we will have CUI also in Oracle. Like see, black and white screen will be there. Whatever we want to get or whatever we want to save, for everything we need to write queries. Next, Oracle versions. See, these many versions have been released. First one is Oracle 1.0, released in 1979. It was containing basic features. Next version is 8, released in 1983. It also contains basic features only. Next, after that, 8i released. It supports internet applications. Okay, the next 9i version release. It supports internet applications as well as ERP, entity relationship. Next, 10G version. It also having a most best features in that version. Okay. Next, 11G. It supports OLTP and OLAP. These are the new features in Oracle. Okay. Next, 12C. Sharing feature and cost of implementing is less. So whatever the database is there, now if you want to implement, if you want to share, that cost is less. Okay. Next, database is nothing but it's a collection of predefined objects. Objects means whatever the tables, views, reports, queries, these and all things are objects only. Okay. Next, components in Oracle database. These are the components: SQL and PLSQL. So SQL full form is structured query language. PLSQL means procedure or procedural language. Okay, so SQL is the basic type and PLSQL is the advanced for SQL. Rules at queries in Oracle database. What are the rules while writing queries? We have to ensure that each query should be end with a semicolon, and SQL queries are not case sensitive. You can write the queries in small letters or capital letters also. You can execute only one query at a time, not multiple queries. You cannot execute multiple queries at a time. Okay. Next, SQL queries accepted by any RDBMS tool. See, that means we can use that queries in Microsoft SQL Server also. Same queries will be there, and in Oracle also same queries. Like we have so many tools, in that also we can use SQL queries. Next, rules at object names. Object names means database objects are nothing but users, tables, views, functions, and so many are there. Okay, in that at the time of writing names of these objects or table names, while writing, you should have think about it. You should have take care about these rules. Okay. See, the name should be begins. The object name should be begins with alphabet, not any special symbol, and not a number. It should not begins with number. Okay. Number are special letters. It should be begin with alphabet only. Next, object name contains small a z. You can use capital A to Z, you can use 0 to 9, you can use, and dollar, hash, underscore, these and all things you can use as a in object name. Okay, object name should not contain any space. So in object name you don't have to use space. Instead of space you can use underscore. Okay, reserved words or predefined words are not valid like commands. See, reserved words means for example table is there, that is reserved word. Views is there, that is reserved word. User is there. So many words are there we are using like commands. Those commands we do not use as a object names in Oracle, in in creating object names. Okay, next, SQL commands types. What commands we have in SQL means we will have some four types of commands: DDL, DML, DCL, DQL. SQL is a database language used to store, manipulate and retrieve data stored in relational database. So why we have to use SQL means to store the data, and to manipulate means to edit and update the data, and retrieve means to get the data stored in a relational database. Next, what is data definition? DDL means the abbreviation of DDL is data definition language. So in this data definition language we'll have three types of commands. What are that? Create, alter, drop. Create, it is used to create a new table or view of table or other object in database. Okay, so we can, with the help of create command, we can create a table, okay. Next, alter, modifies an existing database object such as a table. So if you want to alter, alter means if you want to modify a table name, modify a table means you can use alter command. Okay, next, drop, deletes an entire table, a view of a table or other object in the database. If you want to delete the table means you can use the drop command. Okay, these three commands regarding DDL. Okay, next, DML. DML full form is data manipulation language. See, in that also we have three types, three commands are there. One is insert command, another one is update command, and another last one is delete command. So why we have to use insert command means to create a record, update command why we have to use means to modify records. Next, delete command to delete the records. Now, what is records? See, in a table we will have some columns and rows. For columns we will call as a fields. Okay, for rows we will call here like records. Each row will contain some information about a particular employee or particular product, whatever it may be. Okay, so see, for deleting command, for deleting table we have to use drop command. For creating table we have to use create command. For modifying a table we have to use alter command. But see, to create a record we have to use insert command. To modify a record we have to use update command. To delete a record we have to use delete command. Okay, see, these are the commands. Next, DCL, data control language. In that we have two types of command, two commands are there, and the some more commands also will be there, but these are the main commands. Okay, so grant gives a privilege to user. So it means it gives permissions to user. Okay, with the help of grant command the user will get permission to work with the database. Okay, revoke takes back privileges granted from user. So whatever the permissions you have allotted to user, that you can cancel with the help of this revoke command. Okay, next, data query language, DQL. DQL. So in that we will have one command, select. See, select command is used to retrieve certain records from one or more tables. Okay, this select command is used to get the records from one or more tables. We will use select command. Next, data types. Data types represents a type of data, what type of data you are going to enter. So for that we have to reserve some memory. For that purpose we are using data types. Okay, data type represents type of data used to allocating memory for values in a table. So for the values we have to mention data type, then only memory will be allocated for the values in a table. Okay, we will have some data types like exact numeric data types, floating point numeric data types, date and time data types, character and string data types. Okay, first we will see, we will have so many data types in exact numeric data types, but we will discuss some basic data types. Okay, integer, so it allows the value from these two and this, in between or equal to these values or in between these values, that value it will be taken at the time of execution. If you enter more than these values, more than this value means it won't allow. Okay, it will show error at the time of execution. Next, numeric data type. So these are the values, in between or up to these values it will be taken at the time of execution if you mention numeric data type. Next, floating point numeric data types. Floating means decimal values. This, if you use float data type, means from this value to up to this value it will be taken. Okay, at the time of execution. Next, real. If you use real data type, means from this value to this value it will be taken. Next, date and time data types. Here we have date, time. These three data types are the, from this value to this value it will be accepted. And date data type stores a date like March 26, 2014, like that. It's an example only. Okay, next, time data type. Time data type stores a time of a day like in this format. Okay, next, generally we use data format as DD, means a date, month, year. But Oracle database engine supports date hyphen month hyphen years, like this format it will support. Next, character or strings data types. See, character data type is there. Yeah, it will take the maximum value, maximum length it will take 8000 characters. If you mention data type as character, means 8000 characters it will take, means 1000 bytes, sorry, not 1000 bytes, 8000 bytes it will take. Varchar, the maximum length of 8000 characters. Variable length, non-unicode data. Fixed length means, For example, employee ID is there. There will be some fixed digits, like 7 digits or 8 digits. Aadhaar card is there. There will be some 12 digits. Phone number is there. There will be some 10 digits, like that. Fixed digits we have to use character data type. Varchar means name is there. It will be differ from one person to another person name. That's why we can call it as variable length. Okay, so for variable, now you have got to know that what is variable length. So for variable length we have to use Varchar data type. It also takes 8000 characters. Next, operators in SQL. There are three types of operators in SQL. Those are arithmetic operators, comparison operators, logical operators. Next, arithmetic operators. Plus, minus means addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and modulus. These are the arithmetic operators. Next, comparison operators. See, equal to, not equal to, and less than and greater than, less than, greater than, greater than, less than, greater than or equal to, less than or equal to. Next, not greater, not less than, not greater than. So we all of know that what is these are values. If you want description also, I have written here. So equal to means checks if the values of two operands are equal or not. If yes, then conditions become true. Here also it will check it is not equal to. If the condition is not equal to, means it will give true. The condition will become true, otherwise false. So here also it will check if the values two operands are equal or not. If values are not equal, then conditions become true. Here also checks if the values of left operator is greater than the value of right operand. If yes, then conditions become true. Here also it will check whether the value of the operand is less than value of right operand. Okay, if yes, then condition become true. Check this one also. Checks if the value of left operand is greater than or equal to the value of right operand. If yes, then condition becomes true. Here also checks if the value of left operand is less than or equal to the value of right operand. If yes, then condition become true. Here also checks if the value of left operand is not less than the value of right operand. Okay, if yes, then conditions become true. Here also checks if the value of left operand is not greater than the value of right operand. If yes, then conditions become true. Next, logical operators. We will have this many logical operators in Oracle, in SQL. Okay, the all operator is used to compare a value to all values in another value set, and the AND operator allows the existence of multiple conditions. Suppose if you want to mention more conditions in a particular query, means you can use AND operator. Any operator is used to compare a value to any applicable value in the list according to the condition. The between operator is used to search for values that are within a set of values given the minimum value and the maximum value. Next, exists. The exists operator is used to search for the presence of a row in a specified table that meets certain criteria. Okay. Next, in. The in operator is used to compare a value to a list of literal values that have been specified. The like operator is used to compare a value to similar values using wildcard operators. Not. The not operator reserves the meaning of logical operator with which it is used. Example, not exists, not between, not in, etc. This is a negate operator. Or, the OR operator is used to combine multiple conditions in an SQL statement where clause. So, OR operator where we will use so many conditions. If any conditions true means, if any one condition among the, if any one argument true means condition will become true. Okay, next. The null operator is used to compare a value within a null value. Unique. The unique operator researches every row of a specified table for uniqueness, no duplicates.